Hello everyone, I'm Mihoko. I'll introduce you to one Japanese folktale. The title of this story is The Magic Tea Kettle Sharing Happiness. This story depicts a warm interaction between a raccoon dog and humans. I hope you'll like this story. Thank you. Once upon a time, in a village, there lived a kind old man named Jinbei. Jinbei lived alone in a tiny and poor house. His house was at the mountain foot. He was a farmer, but his farm was so small that he could not grow many vegetables. He had a good friend living in the mountain. Who was his friend? It was a raccoon dog named Ponkichi. Look! Here he comes. Good morning, Jinbei. Oh, Ponkichi, you are always welcome. If you are hungry, you can eat these fresh corns. Jinbei smiled. Thank you. In fact, I'm starving to death. Wow, this corn is very nice. While tasting fresh corns, hungry Ponkichi thought, Jinbei has always shared various foods with me. His farm is very small. I know he is poor. I'd like to do something for him. Well, I've got a good idea. Ponkichi got excited about his plan to help Jinbei make money. Jinbei, thank you for your delicious corns. Have a good day. Bye. Ponkichi hurried away and changed his position. Behind Jinbei's back, Ponkichi changed into something. What sound was that? In surprise, Jinbei turned back. Oh, it's a tea kettle. Who placed such a beautiful kettle here? Jinbei also found a letter beside it. This is a letter for me. What does it say? This is a present for you, Jinbei. Bring this kettle to the temple, and the priest will buy it for a good price. What a price! Anyway, thanks God. I'll do so. Jinbei hurried to the temple, carrying the kettle. At the temple, Hello, Master. Please look at this tea kettle. How do you like it? When Jinbei showed the tea kettle to the priest, the eyes of the priest shone with pleasure. How wonderful! You are selling to me? Why did you know I've wanted a good tea kettle now? I'll give you one gold coin for this kettle. Thank you, Master. Jinbei received one gold coin and happily went back home. The priest was also very happy with the beautiful tea kettle. He ordered the boy, Now we'll make tea with this kettle. Boil the water in this kettle. Certainly, Master. After washing the tea kettle, the young priest filled it with water and placed it over a charcoal fire. Soon, the kettle was getting warm and the water inside was also getting warm. The water made sounds when it got hot. Suddenly, the kettle began to shake and jumped up. Hot, hot, I'm burning. And what do you know? With a shouting voice, there appeared legs, a tail, and head of a raccoon dog. Wow, wow, monster kettle, monster kettle! Help, help! The priest and the boy kept running around with screaming. On the other hand, the raccoon dog with a tea kettle was also screaming, ouch, ouch, I'm burning, I'm burning, I'm burning. Then it disappeared. Back in Jinbei's farm, coo, coo. Oh, it's Ponkichi. What happened? Why are you crying? Why are you in a tea kettle? Ponkichi told the whole story to Jinbei. So, you changed into a kettle to help me make money. How kind you are. Jinbei was greatly moved. Poor Ponkichi, I have a good medicine. I'll apply it to your burn. In a few days, Ponkichi completely recovered. Thank you, Jinbei. Now I'm fine. That's good. Jinbei smiled. If you feel fine, let's go and see the priest to return a gold coin. It's not a good money. Okay, Jinbei, I will. Although Ponkichi agreed, he was still thinking, Jinbei has been so nice to me. I wish I could do something for him. When Jinbei and Ponkichi arrived at the temple, the summer festival was held in the yard. All the village people gathered and enjoyed dancing there. Jinbei and Ponkichi found the priest among the people and went close to him, greeting. Good evening, Master.
Good evening, Master.
The priest was surprised to see Ponkichi. Oh, you are that kettle. Ponkichi, you scared me.
I'm sorry, Master. I came here to return this gold coin to you.
Ponkichi explained the reason. Now I see. Ponkichi, you are a good raccoon dog. You deserve this gold coin. You can keep it.
Thank you, Master. In return for your kindness, I'd like to show my performance to all of you.
Saying that, Ponkichi went up the tree and stood on a tightrope between the trees.
Everybody, may I have your attention, please? I'm a raccoon dog with a tea kettle. You are especially invited to my acrobatics you have never seen before. I hope you'll enjoy them.
Then, Ponkichi began to walk on the rope while singing and dancing. Boom, buku, boom, buku, boom, buku, boom, buku, boom, buku, 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 happy sound. I'm a raccoon dog sharing happiness. Boom, buku, 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 makes you smile. I'm a raccoon dog sharing happiness. Boom, buku, 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 makes you smile. Boom, buku, boom, buku, boom, buku, boom, buku, boom, buku, 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 happy sound. I'm a raccoon dog sharing happiness. Boom, buku, 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 makes you smile. Boom, buku, 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 makes you smile. Bye! The village people cheered and gave big hands to Ponkichi. The performance was over. The village people went back home feeling very happy. When Ponkichi went down the tree, he found lots of coins under the lanterns. That was the money the village people gave to Ponkichi for his performance. Ponkichi said to the priest and Jinbei,
Master, I'll give you half of this money. Please spend it for the village people. And Jinbei, I'll give you another half because you have been so nice to me.
Thank you, Ponkichi. That's a good idea. Pongchi shared happiness with many people. Since then, in the village, from generation to generation, people have talked about the magic tea kettle sharing happiness called Bumbuku Chagama. This is the end of the story.